All right, yep. Let's see what John Key can offer you now. Were you gazumped today, John Key?
Oh, not at all. I mean, we expected them to throw the kitchen sink at it, or at least try to do it. I guess the question New Zealanders will be asking is, why have they waited 9 years to get a $16 block of cheese, you know, after such a long time?
You said in Parliament today these tax cuts were too little.
Yeah.
Now, you said on Monday you're talking about cuts north of 50 bucks.
Well, that's what the expectations of New Zealanders are. You'll have to wait and see our tax package. But what I can say to you is, we see tax as a number one priority issue.
But hang on, but Monday you said, when you said the expectations of that, you're implying you would deliver on that.
Well, actually, that's what Mel and Julian have indicated tonight, that those kind of numbers are there. Now,
but $50 for an individual or for a household?
Oh, look, that was the expectation of individuals. Now, you know, we had a tax package in 2005. I remember being on close-up show with Michael Cullen saying it was reckless, it was unaffordable, it was undeliverable. It would have delivered $45 a week to someone on $50,000. Mel and Julian would have been better off by more than $60 had we been the government in 2005. Today, Michael Cullen's saying in worse economic conditions, it's somehow possible. Well, you know, look, it's about economic management, and I think we've got a much better sense of where we want to take New Zealand.
If, say, for instance, you know, say someone is single, they don't have families, they're not into working for families, all that sort of stuff, they could expect a $50 a week tax cut under National.
Well, they'll have to see how much they earn, and they'll have to see our package when we rolled out. But what I can say, it's the number one priority. We see that as hugely important, not just because of the amount of money, Mark. I mean, that is crucially important. I mean, people paying, you know, very high interest rates, very high costs, but also about putting the right incentives in the economy. We need to encourage people to back themselves, to back New Zealand, to want to work hard and want to get ahead. It's not solely just about dollars in the hand.
But let's cut to the chase. Under National, you'll get a bigger tax relief than you do under this budget.
Well, as I say, you have to wait and see our package, but
that's a simple, well, that's a simple enough thing.
Today, I mean, today is the government's day to announce their tax package. That's what the budget is about.
Because people, I mean, like Mel and Julian, they want to see the colour of your money. And they're saying,
so they absolutely
in principle, you'll be looking at bigger tax cuts under National than under Labor.
Well, what I can say to you is, it's our number one priority. Now, people can look into that however they like, but what I'm saying is it's extremely important. People have waited an awfully long time, and they deserve better than that. And it is quite possible to achieve a lot more. I mean, let's just take...
But is it? Because when I said to you, have you been gazumped? It looks as though, and you hear the commentators today, Michael Cullen's emptied the treasure chest. There ain't no more dough.
No, Michael Cullen has decided what his set of priorities are. Now, this is a finance minister who back in 2005 and back in 2002 never wanted to deliver tax cuts. Okay, so he's got a set of priorities, and that includes, for instance, building an embassy in Sweden, having more people on the foreign affairs circuit, and all those kinds of things. I say to New Zealanders, at a time where you're paying a lot more for your costs, where interest rates have doubled under Labor, you're the number one priority, not all of the fancy things that governments might spend on.
But cutting an embassy in Sweden isn't going to finance bigger tax cuts. I mean, it's got to, because, and you know that what's thrown at you by the government is you're going to get in there and you're going to slash public services to pay for anything you come up with.
We're not going to slash public services, but let's make one thing clear. We are going to halt the size of the bureaucracy out of Wellington. 26,000 core bureaucrats has grown to 36,000. We've said enough's enough. Under Labor's plan...
So 10,000 will get the chop under you?
No, they won't have to get the chop. We'll stay at 36,000. There's natural attrition. People come and go. But under Labor's plan, that will cost $500 million more to continue to grow the bureaucracy. We're saying New Zealanders come before more bureaucrats in Wellington.
I mean, this is the start of the election campaign, isn't it? It is the start. Now, people are saying this was yours to lose, given the polls. Have you lost it today?
Oh, certainly not. I mean, look, we are going to roll out to New Zealanders a very credible plan for New Zealand, and it will be about lifting wages, it'll be about better conditions, but it'll also be about being a safer society, about a better society. So, no, there's a long way to run this.
All right, John Key, thanks for your time. We'll check out what the Thorburns think. So, well, vote to National after that.
I can't say I'm dead set running off to give my vote to National.
We've
from that.
We've got to wait and see the colour of the money.
So you want to see detail from John Key and National?
Yeah. Definitely. There's been a lot of talk, and it's promising, and it's nice to know that over the next few months there'll be some back and forth and some more things to consider. So we'll just have to wait and see.
So just to recap, you guys were reasonably happy with some of the dollars, but it's the fact you're having to wait for the full implementation has got you.
Yeah, and there's definitely an element there to a little bit, you know, a bit late, too little too late sort of thing. But, I mean, it's coming, but is it going to be enough, you know, right now when we're feeling the pinch?
Hey, listen, thanks, guys. Well, I hope things start getting a bit better for you.
Thank you.
All right,
thank
now you. For a quick political sum up of today's budget, we're joined by our commentator, Therese Arsenault. Now, Therese, who came out of today on top?
I think it was a good budget for Labor. I think it was a very cunning budget. It, at the very least, it's provided some tax cuts, some tax relief, and it has also, of course, buoyed social spending as well. And that's got to be Labor's message. If they're going to have any shot in this election, it's getting that balance.
I mean, when you say cunning, it was because we were sold, our expectations were lowered, weren't they?
They were definitely lowered. I certainly was surprised at the size of the tax cuts. But I think what's really cunning about it is it can be a two-step plan. I mean, it might win them the election, or it might at least get them back some of their core support. If that doesn't work, at the very least, what it's done is put into place tonight their tax cut package and their social spending. And I'm not really sure if National even wins the election, what money they're going to have to spend. How are they going to up the tax cuts?
See, are votes still up for grabs? I mean, you often hear people say, oh, people make up their minds months out, even some have already decided. How fluid is this election?
We are a volatile electorate. In political science terms, we've studied this, and in the last election, 40% of the voters decided during the election campaign. The one before that, it was 60%. So there's still a lot of votes up for grab.
Now, you talked about the concern over social spending, but this has put tax... It's going to become a bidding war, isn't it? I mean, we'd expect National to come out and say, they're offering you this, we're offering you more.
Well, the big question is, if National outbids Labor on the tax cut, how are they going to fund it? And if, you know, we had a quick look at the books today, Michael Collins says that's all the money there is. What sort of cuts? People are going to want to know that. And I think now the focus really is on National. That, you know, Labor shot, set off a shot across their bow. It's now up to National to respond, give us some details about how they would fund their tax cuts.
I know some people say elections are boring. This one's going to be a cracker.
It's going to be exciting.
I'm going to see a lot more of you during that campaign. That's it for us tonight. That's New Zealand Close Up.